All right, so this was one that I live streamed yesterday, but for some reason the GoPro, well, the GoPro overheated, as GoPros are known to do. I guess that's why people are stopping purchasing GoPros and picking up like Insta360s and DJI action cameras. But yeah, I was live streaming yesterday and it didn't allow me to save the stream. It actually just ended the live stream because the camera overheated. So I'm gonna try to go through it element by element. All right, here we go, live streaming. So yeah, this will be a little different because I'm not actually making it, but you'll get to hear what I did. So let me just go in here and mute everything, I guess. I guess that's the best way to do it. Okay. All right, let's go to the drums. And I'm gonna solo these drums. So I'm in 100, I'm in 76 BPM, it's a little bit slower. And this is the vinyl drum machines from Mars. Now let's let it play. These drum machine kits, vinyl drum machine from Mars kits, sound amazing. Like, you guys should pick these up. Fifth drum machine from Mars kit, it's the BDLXR low vinyl, that's the name of the kick. Sharp Bright is the name of the snare. You guys should check these out. I'm gonna go on to the next one. So the next MIDI track we have, I used the Jurasynth and I used a preset called Abandon. So let me run that. It's just three stabs of the chords. It's got that 80s sound. I put an air multi-chorus on it. I put an analog delay. And of course I put an auto pan on it. Let's move over to the audio tracks now. So there's a bass, which I'll play first, and that goes a little something like that. Ooh, let me mute all of the, you go in here and take solo off of the MIDI tracks. All right, we'll go back to the audio and I'll run the bass for you guys. I love the way this bass sounds. So I went into the vintage compressor and then the air amp sim, and then I added air flavor to it, like for some tube warmth. And the bass is actually how I started this beat. I start from the bass a lot of the times because I learned a long time ago that when you listen to the bass in music, all the other frequencies fill themselves in around it and you get the best experience. And so a lot of times I end up writing from a bass line. So next we have the first guitar. And this one is pretty simple, like kind of funky picking licks. Put an air compressor on it and then into the amp sim, and then I added a quick delay and then some spring reverb, but with the mix way down, because by default the spring reverb patch in the MPC 1 has like 100% mix, and you just don't want that. As a guitar player, it's very rare that you would want 100% on the mix on your reverb, unless you're trying to make it real ambient or something. But I wasn't going for that here. I need some pick attack. So yeah, that's the first guitar. Now let's get to the second guitar, and then I'll play them all for you guys. Here we go. Now this one is some double stops with the octave. It's my George Benson, Wes Montgomery impersonation. Not that I can play as well as those guys, but I do love them. So this one, I didn't use an amp synth sim. I used Air Flavor, and then I used the flanger, and then of course, my auto pan that I love so much. And I love the way this guitar sounds. And I use my Stratocaster for these guitars. All right, so now I'm gonna play the whole thing, or I'm gonna play the sequence so far. You know how it is. Later on, I'm gonna sequence this out and I'll upload it later. So let me take that off solo, and here's the whole thing. Happier with this one than I've been with a good deal of these. So I think I'm gonna sequence this one out first. I'm gonna move it to the front of the queue. There's about six, maybe seven more that I need to sequence out. I'm gonna do this one first because I like the energy this one has, and I just like the way the guitar is, the bass, and those Jura synth stabs are playing together. So I'm really excited about this one. I can't wait to sequence it out. That'll be the next video. Unless I get some kind of idea like this and try to live stream again, which if the inspiration comes, I will do, but I just know better than to try to use the GoPro. So I guess I'll just live stream from my phone, because the A7 III, as far as I can find, won't allow you to live stream from it. So gotta make do with what I got. I do love the A7 III though. Thank you guys for watching. Look out for the sequence version. Peace. Good morning. It is just about 8:05 a.m. right now. I'm gonna make some coffee and get ready for the rest of my day.